Hello there, my name is Amin Mamedov, I represent the company IT-Sputnik, and in this video I want to tell a bit more about email marketing or how you can create email campaign inside of a Bitrix. First of all, you can create it here in email campaign. To get in that box, you need to create marketing, then go to email marketing. And the following steps are quite simple, actually. You need to select one of the templates from here and create a segment or select segment, put subject, put some body, test it for some email, your email, of course, and then just send. So let's dive in and look a bit in detail. First of all, you need to select segment, but you have no segment, you need to create one. You click create, then you need to click on clients, which is your existing clients like contacts or deals, and select some deals, for example, by a certain criteria. For example, if you select a deal, you can select by, for example, some pipeline. In that test portal, I got only one pipeline, which is general, and for example, all deals in pipeline general with, for example, in progress status, you can select, and then it will be selected all emails which is available by certain criteria. The same thing you can do for the leads, and also you can import data, just put a list of emails, this is example, and using that emails, Bitrix will create some segment. Then when you're done with segment, let's say that, you need to put some subject, test subject, and modify the body of email. It's just the same simple as a create website using some builders. So for example, you deleting that, and you can put here friends, we'll see you somewhere. Okay, we can leave that text. When you save it, probably it's not was not good idea to save. But if you've done the same mistake as me, you can go back to campaigns and see campaigns which you created and edit it right here. So delete that. Then you can put some additional documents, select a priority, use a UTM parameters. And then send test email, first of all, for yourself, just to test it. If you like the test, just click apply, and then, for example, select the time when it will be selected. For example, later, now manually schedule. So you can select a time when you're going to send. Or you can send manually right now. Now, close, go to campaigns, so it's already sent it. And actually in campaign you can see it that it's not sending under sending status, and you can send it manually again. For example, if you create a campaign, email campaign, I will create any. Later manually, save. So you can see that campaign, and you can click send now, right? So it's sending. So you can create your campaign in advance. You have it in list, and then send it. You could decide or schedule like send campaign, for example, send one email, then another one. And actually, you can create a campaign based on business process, but this is another talk. Okay, so main thing, campaigns, segments, and templates. So segments which you created, you can find here. All segments right here. Let's have a look on real client. So we have a real campaign, which already sent. And we got the same templates here, where you can create some. And with that real client, you get segments. If you go to the segment, you can see that we divided segments by the cities where the client located. And for each segment, you can see number of emails. If you go inside of that segment, you can see the filter which you used. In that case, we've done a selection for the deals, which is in that pipeline and in that city, Ziegen, right? And the system automatically select all emails which located or assigned to that particular city. So when we send emails, I can see that statistic. So I can see statistic emails list, sent, opened or not. So for all emails, I can see that, and I can use a filter to see who is not opened email, who didn't click or click, and so on. Also, very important step here is about which email you're going to use for the sending. When you create a campaign, inside of template, you're selecting sender, right? So if you're going to send emails for clients, which is your current clients, and you're sure that they will not send your email to the spam folder, and high likely that will open it, so you can use your personal email, but not for too much, for example, not more than 1,000, 2,000 emails. But if you're going to send your email marketing for your potential clients and it will look like more like a spam, you need to use another email which used external SMPT. So what I'm saying that, I mean, when you're going to connect your email in mailbox settings, you need to, for example, you can connect your current email for IMAP. But for SMPT means that which SMPT you use for to send emails, you need to use send exist using external SMPT. For now, for one of our client, we use a SendGrid. So we use IMAP for regular email, but for external SMPT, we use SMPT server, port, APK as login and some password for APK. And actually the funny thing that in Twilio, which is SendGrid, you got very funny reports. You can see the same who opened, how long they viewed, and many other information. Probably it will be necessary for your reporting. But again, if you send emails for somebody who is more likely will open your mail, you can use regular integration of mailbox. But if you're going to use email campaign for something like spam or from potential client, it's much better to use external SMPT. So that's it actually. If you have a questions, ask questions in comments under that video. If you like that video, click like. Thank you and bye-bye.